at an average cost of about $11 per share. The total holdings of 150,000 shares were then retired and cancelled. These facts, thus briefly stated, illustrate the vicious possibilities inherent in permitting managements to exercise discretionary powers to purchase shares with the company's funds. We note first the painful contrast between the treatment accorded to the